Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning to you all. Good morning to all listeners and viewers on Hope of Glory Network Radio. Today is Sunday morning, and your pastor is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Chirenkansa of Hope of Glory Network TV on Facebook, Hope of Glory Network Radio, Hope of Glory Network Prayer Line in Maryland, United States. You will be blessed today. Stay blessed. Call your friends and your neighbors to come and join us. God richly bless you. Let's continue. Every soul of There is no one like you. Hallelujah. God richly bless you. We're used to here with Hope of Glory Network Radio. Your pastor this morning is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Trenkansa, United States, Maryland. God richly bless you. I come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you.
Amen.
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 Kanda Barayanda. I want you to begin with prayer with me and thank the Lord this morning where you are. In the name of Jesus. I want us to begin to pray and thank the Lord for this morning. Let's thank the Lord for His mercy, for His glory. Oh, Jesus, just give praise to Jesus, our Lord and King, the Almighty. Shall we praise Him for all that He does in our life? My God, day, Ramama, Yabawasira, day, oh, Jehovah, Yeshirao, Yankupon, Tiatifoya, Najawasu. Yeah, the one that sin won't come for no one to come now. Yes, to Dinimo, Yadawasin. You are you in the mighty name of Jesus. Mage, Liziranda Baba. You who are you are you. What you know on my name, that was you. Our Lord and King and ruling King. Our sovereign God. Oh, Almighty God. We bless your name. We bless your name. Jesus, we bless your name. Jesus, we bless your name. Jesus, we give you glory. Jesus, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes. My God and King, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We bless your name in Jesus' name. We glorify you in the name of Jesus. Oh, yes, Jehovah. Manaria bros, Gitoro Marade, Baranda bros. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah, that was you. Oh, we give you glory for this morning. We thank you for this morning. We thank you for this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Our God and King. Hey, our sovereign King. Our ruling King. Our deliverer. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Our healer. Yeah, 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 yeah. Our provider. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, our everything in life in Jesus' name. We glorify your name, my God. We glorify your name, our King. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mother day, yeah, 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 yeah. You deserve the glory. You deserve the glory. Man, lady, brother, and the rabbi, yeah, yeah, yeah. Malababro, Yendelebe, Ilebarababro, Ilebazakibro, Yendelebe, Yadawasi Eradi, Yadawasi Oinkasian, Yadawasi Abumura, Wayanazadi, yes, to Dinimo, Mandarababro, Yendelebe, Rekabo, Randarababe, Lirimurubo, Yandarababe, Maharian, the Bru, Yandarababe. In the mighty name of Jesus, yeah, you are you. Or do for no one when you know, don't finish your step for. I him who in a rebel ride, I was saying. Well, you're not ready, yes, to Christ of Jenimo. By a Sakayaba, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God richly bless you. We continue to pray. We have a few minutes to begin the word of God. So we're going to pray for, this is a new Sunday. It's a new week. We have begun a new week from today. And we're going to commit ourselves, our life, our jobs, our finances, our husbands, our wives, our children. We're going to commit our homes, our families. Our leaders, we're going to commit our pastors, our everything. We commit it into the hands of the Lord. We are asking the Lord to lead and to take absolute control in the name of Jesus. We are saying that God, everything that Satan has planned this week, we stand in the blood of Jesus, we destroy. We stand in the blood of Jesus. Oh, yes, we free ourselves. We ask for freedom. We ask for protection. Divine favor. As we begin a new week, as we go through the week, in the mighty name of Jesus. Can you pray with me? In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Linda Brayaba. Hey. Le Maria Bro Kabade Aya. Manda Bro Yende Bro. Le Manda Bro Yande Bebe Aya. Linda Bro Kabro Indili Baba. Bro. Le Babarian de Bro Yaya. Ye La Vasa Kabaya. Bariando Bro Lobo Sicilian de Rebe Aya. Lera mama mama mama, limbro kimbro jimbro jindarababe. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the ready Jesus Christ's name, baya baba ya ya ya, lela babro yandarababe ya ya, lera babro yandelebelebe ya ya, robro yandelebe ya ya, lele zekerinda babro yandebro ya ya. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Christo Dinamo. Yes, Christo Dinamo. What don't follow up for? What am I going to do? What did you for? Yeah. Mahayanda Braya Kataya. Mariande Bruya Labazundere. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Halabori and the Brokindere Baya Baba. Yes, Christo Dinamo. Lema Mama Mama. Yeah. Yera baboya ba, yera babroka ba ya ba, le manda braya mbiri ya ba. In the name of Jesus, in the raya ya buri ya baba. Wa yana radi Yesu Christo jinemo. Oh, we ask for divine favor this week. We ask for divine protection this week. We ask that the Lord, you send your angels to protect us, to go with us in everything we do. We commit it into your hands. Father, I commit my wife into your hands. I commit my ministry into your hands. I commit my ministry into your hands. Yeah. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. What in Cassia? What money? What you for not do for? Already, yes, you dynamo. Already, cow and guano for no one of pain. Why you're not ready, yes, to Christo dynamo? Why you're not ready, yes, to Christo dynamo? Legabo robo yindele bro sakaya mama. Ramande bro yindele rasakiri anda bro. In the mighty name of Jesus. Ahimohini Orero Moria Sandarababrosi Toro Magabayaba. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yadawasi. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Amen. I want us to sing this song. You can join me sing this song. Let's sing this song before the word of God with Sonny Baby. With Sonny Baby.
Oh, no.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, God richly bless you. God richly bless you. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. My Akaya Bari and the Rusticatu and the Lava. Hi, 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 hi. My God, I give you glory and I praise your name this morning. I glorify your name for your people, for your servants, for your daughters, for all your children, for this ministry, for this new week that, Lord, you have given us the necessary opportunity. We have everything that we need in life as children of God. So we give you glory, we praise your name. Father, we continue to ask you to be with us, to pour afresh your spirit on us, and to rub every satanic oppression from our soul, spirit, and body in the name of Jesus. Help us to stand strong and grow in grace and in favor of the Lord and in the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Father, as I stand in the authority name of our Lord Jesus Christ, as an anointed servant of God, I bind every principality, power of darkness, every witchcraft manipulation, every ancestral spirit, every territorial spirit, I bind them. And I put them in chains in the name of Jesus Christ. And I make a declaration that they cannot work against any child of God, or they will not work against any child of God. Accordingly, I stand in the name of authority of our Lord Jesus. I silence every demon, every power that has name. Because the name of our God has been exalted above every name in Jesus' name. So, sisters and brothers, I deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that you'll be healed right now in Jesus' name. I pray that your freedom will be given to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that the Lord will open the windows of heaven and to remember you like he remembered Noah and his children after the flood, after your problem, after your stress, after all that you have gone through. God is about to remember you today. God is about to remember you today in the name of Jesus Christ. So I thank God for what he has started doing in your life. God will give you glory that, Lord, as we wait for your second coming, you are preparing us for wonderful things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God richly bless you. So, your pastor again is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Trent Cancer, United States, Maryland, of Hope of Glory Network TV on Facebook, Hope of Glory Network Radio. You can get us on the Ghana web and Hope of Glory Network prayer line. I always say thank you to my prayer line members. They have been with me for almost 9 years to 10 years. God richly bless you guys. Mummies and daddies, brothers and sisters, I love you all for you always standing behind in me in the name of Jesus. Your labor will never be in vain, and God will keep you safe and give you good health in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This morning, let's open our Bibles to the book of First John chapter verse number 9. First John chapter number. Can you please help me if you are on the prayer line? Please. If you are on the prayer line and you are in the kitchen, please help me. The noise. I'm talking about those who are making noise. Please. Because I have other people from different areas that are listening to us. Right. I'm talking to you on the prayer line. So I'm going to mute. I'm going to mute. Let me see if I can put everyone on mute. Why I minister, because Facebook for am from to munya but sama why na me control wonga omo ye dede e wo prayer line so no sana da ya omo omo ye dede o prayer line, let me control them, let me put every one of them in mute first so that I can minister to you. God richly bless you. God richly bless you. That's funny. When I put everyone on mute, I forget to put myself as the organizer. So forgive me, sorry for the interruption. Okay. So our dear sister in Connecticut, you are the only one that is not on mute. So help me. If there is no noise, I know there is no noise coming from your side. Our sister in Connecticut, you have 203 number. You are the only one I have unmuted you. God richly bless you. Okay, so please, let's continue. What is this? Our sister in Connecticut, I said, don't put your phone on mute. You put your phone on mute and you mess me up. Okay. Thank you. Hi. In the name of Jesus, Father, I thank you. I give you glory for the special anointing given to me to minister to your people this morning again. Continue to bless us with the spiritual blessings and in heavenly blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so open your Bibles to the book of 1 John chapter number 1 verse 9. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9. And looking at your screen on Facebook today, what is the topic that God has given to us? God still remembered you. God still remembers you. He remembered you. Okay? He keep remembering you every day. He remember you. Do you know God remember you in everything? Yes. God remembers you in every area of your life. Your life may be, or may seem to be ups and down, but it doesn't mean God has forgotten you. You may be doing something that is not right, but that does not mean God has forgotten you or he has left you, okay? Let me read a scripture from the book of 1 John chapter number 1 verse number 9. Verse number 9. I think somebody said, I don't like when I'm ministering and some people are making noise to distract me. Okay, so let's see what it says in verse number 9. Sorry, go to the wrong place. It says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Verse 10. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. Okay. You see, in America here, or in the world today, by the grace of technology, there is something that is called DNA. And DNA is a test that can determine or can answer the question of who Mr. A or Mr. B is, meaning which family does he or she come from. Sometimes DNA could prove whether this child is the father of a particular man or not, especially today that women can do anything and then can come to men and say, this is my this is your son. You understand what I'm talking about? So DNA help us to prove identity of people. And in the divine DNA, in the divine DNA, it is proved that all men have sinned and have come short of the glory of God. That is the divine DNA. It means our divine DNA proved that all men have sinned and have come short of the glory of God. Amen. So it means all men are not righteous. The reason all men are not righteous is because we are the ancestors of Abraham. We are all from the generation of Abraham. So we have all sinned by blood. It is the blood of Adam that is in every human being. It is the blood of Abraham that is in every human being. Hallelujah. My God. So this is the main reason why you, when you see people who discriminate and who practice or always being racist, telling some people that because of your color, you are not a human being, they don't know what they are saying. Because when we cut your body, the same blood that will come from your body, it is the same blood that comes from the white man, Indian, Chinese body. Blood is blood. And all blood can be traced to Adam. We are all from the same place. The reason why I'm saying this is because our scripture today, which is from the book of 1 John chapter 1 verse 9, says, especially verse number 10, which we can repeat reading again, verse number 10. It says, if we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. So there is nobody that can say to himself, I am not a sinner. We have all sinned. Listen, we live righteous life by the grace of God. We live righteous life by the grace of God. The Bible says, for God so loved the world. He loved the world that apart from all the sinful nature of mankind, He, God, gave his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, as a ransom. You understand what it means by a ransom? Ransom is a empata. Onyankopon, Jesus Christ, my answer, empata. I remember when I was a child at my village. If you are with your husband or with your wife, and your wife go for another man or sleep with another man, or your husband go and sleep with another woman and you catch him red-handed, or you find out that your wife is sleeping with somebody or your husband is sleeping with somebody, with evidence, I'm not saying speculation, with evidence, then it comes to a point that your wife or your husband will be mad at you. Who is that? Your husband or your wife will be mad at you, and sometimes it comes as a result of divorce. Normally, what has to reunite the relationship is a ransom. The man demands a ransom from the woman, or the woman demands a ransom from the man. And in those days, I remember when it happens that they set seats for people to come together, and the elders come in, and then they say, okay, you have to give your wife a ransom. And sometimes they ask the man to provide certain things that are, in those days, we consider it as valuable. Something like Dumas, that is Holland cloth, or sewing machine. And depending on the level of the case, some of them, they even ask them to provide a ram. So yes, sir. You understand? So what that I'm saying is that when God saw that mankind have sinned against him, and the sin is so tarnished of our image, or the sin has so tarnished our image, God provided a sacrificial blood to cleanse us. So when you go to the book of Genesis, when Adam sinned and God came to the throne, do you know what he did? He didn't even want to talk to Adam in the first place. God did something first before talking to Adam. Immediately that he found out Adam has sinned, God slaughtered an animal and used the skin of an animal to cover or to clothe Adam. Before that, you know, when Adam himself found out he has sinned, he tried to cover his sin with leaves. Adam covered his sin with leaves. Today is the same thing. We sin and we try to cover our sins with excuses. We cover the iniquity that we are doing, the sinful nature that we are doing, we cover it with excuses. And you know, the kind of excuses we do cover with our sins, we use the word of God. We quote the word of God. We can even say, in the Old Testament, the priests, they have a rope with a big chain. So as a pastor, I also need to put on a big chain, and then a long cloth, and then have a special ring. You understand? As a pastor, I believe that the special ring every man of God, and the only special ring every man of God supposed to have is this ring. In this modern day, I'm talking about in the Church of Grace. I'm talking about in Church of Grace. The grace that has given to us is so much that if you have your only ring that identifies you as a married man or a woman, that is enough.
That is enough. Those things that were happening in the Old Testament, in theology, we call it typology, type. And in typology, it means shadow. So when the priests were wearing all kinds of chains and then all kinds of rings, it was a shadow of our Lord Jesus Christ. They stood or stand for our Lord Jesus Christ. In the book of Hebrews, it says that when the real thing appeared, we no longer worship the image. You see, when during the day, if you are coming, you know your shade. Your shade comes first. That is what was in the Old Testament. When Jesus Christ was coming to save us, his shade was in the Old Testament, and that is what they were doing. When Jesus Christ came to redeem us, we no longer do those things again. So I don't know which those pastors who quote scriptures like that. I don't know how they learned the Bible. So let me go back, coming back to that God still remembered you. He still remembers you, sisters and brothers. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So God did something to save mankind right from the beginning when Adam sinned in the Garden of Eden. So at the fullness of the appointed time, he called or he gave his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believeth in him, on his name, will not perish. That means some people will perish for their sins if they don't repent. That means you will perish if you don't repent. Because according to the book of Hebrews chapter 9:27, it's appointed unto every man to die once, and after death, judgment. So there is going to be a judgment. But let's go to our topic, God still remembers you. In the book of 1 John chapter number 1 verse 9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So, because the DNA of sinful nature is in us, we confess Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior. All right. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 1 verse 12, as many as believe on his name, he gave them power to become children of God. So once we confess Jesus Christ, according to the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 10, is that chapter 10 verse 8 and 9, sorry, chapter 10 verse 8 and 9, it says that where is all that, let me quickly quote it right from the Bible to support all that I'm saying. Romans chapter 8, let's go there, Romans chapter 8 verse chapter 10, verse 8 and 9. Let's see, verse 8 and 9 of the book of Romans, chapter number 10. I'm just trying to make references to the moment we come to Jesus Christ. Our sins are forgiven. So, where is that? Come on. Verse 8 and 9. But what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth, and in your heart, that is the word of faith which we preach. That if you confess with your mouth that Jesus or the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So this is what we do in order to receive salvation from our Lord Jesus Christ. You must first believe in your heart and then let that belief be in action by confessing Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. So if you have not confessed Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, that means I recommend, or you can do that today. And I hear Jehovah's Witness people normally telling people that confessing Jesus Christ is not enough. So in their religion, they don't Jehovah's Witnesses don't recommend that you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Because they make reference that if you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, and it doesn't do anything to you. You understand? But let me tell you, you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, and that doesn't end there, because Paul knows that we are sinful men. We have the DNA of sin. Okay? So we cannot be 100% one day. You cannot be 100% one day. It takes only the grace of God, according to the book of Ephesians, chapter number 2, verse 8. So when you read Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2, 12 verse 1, it says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. So you see how how Paul is begging believers after receiving Jesus Christ. He's not talking to sinners. He's talking to believers that we should do everything possible daily to submit ourselves or to surrender our five senses, which always lead us to sin. You know, it is our five senses that always lead us to sin. So please, verse 2, it says that, and do not conform to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So renewing means that do it every day, every day. That is why in the book of Romans chapter 10, verse 17 says, but faith comes by hearing, and hearing of the word of God, or of the word of Jesus Christ. So let me go back to my point now. So you cannot be 100% and say that you are righteous, or you are 100%, you don't sin. That is what I'm trying to say. I say we have been made righteous by the grace of God through the blood of Jesus, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, that he who knew no sin became sin for us, that we might be righteous in Jesus Christ. So you are righteous. But the fact is that you don't have to let the grace and say, because of grace, grace, grace. So every day you fall in sin and you come and repent. You fall in sin and you come and repent. That is not the point I'm trying to make here. Because according to the Bible, in the book of 1 John, it says, confess your sins. Now, let me tell you, John was not talking to unbelievers. Apostle John, he was not speaking to unbelievers. He knew the people he was talking to that they have accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior. They speak in tongues. They do everything as Christians. But John is saying that if still, as children of God, we confess our sins, our God will forgive us all the sins, because he knew that as human beings, they say that to err is human. Bone batenipa ho. Do ya denyara. We buy a bone. So you're so fool. So you're funny. You still do some sins, which you must always go before the Lord and say, God, forgive me for what I did. Speaking against somebody. Thinking evil against somebody. You see, they are all sin. Sin is not only fornication. Sin is not only going to juju man. But anything that is sinful, you must ask for forgiveness. By biting, slander, which is chunk of 419, they are all sin. You see, so John is saying, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us. Some people don't want to forgive the sins of their neighbors. But you see, God says, if we, human beings, confess our sins, if we will not hide our sins, if we will not cover our sins like Adam did in the Garden of Eden, God said he will forgive us. So, sisters and brothers, no matter where you have been, no matter what you have done, no matter what you did, that does not determine your destiny. What you did today or what you do does not determine, or what I'm trying to say, that those things recognize that today that you have become a child of God, those things does not supersede the salvation work that God did for you. They do not supersede the salvation work that God did for you to save you, or did to save you. So when God designed the plan of your life, it wasn't dependent on you being perfect. Let me tell you, did God come to save the perfect, the righteous, those people who think that they are holy? Is that how God came to the world to save people? So let me say this to you one more time. When God designed your salvation or your life, it wasn't depend on you being a perfect man before he saved you. God is not looking for perfect people to save them. God is looking for sinners to save them. You remember Zacchaeus? When we go to the book of John chapter number 19, it talks about that short man. He is described as a very short man in the Bible. That is Luke chapter 19, right? Let's go there. Luke chapter 19, which we can read from verse number 1, at least a little bit forward. A little bit forward, that talks about Zacchaeus. Let me read. Sometimes it's good to read the Rhema or the logo to transmit it in the Rhema for us. Okay. So then Jesus entered. I'm reading from the book of Luke chapter 19, verse 1 going. At least, let me read a couple of verses here. So, my studio sometimes is dark, so let me see if I can pull light a little bit. Yes, great. Okay, it says that, then Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. Now behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector, and he was rich. And he sought to see who Jesus was, but could not because of the crowd, for he was a short man. So he ran ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was going to pass that way. And when Jesus Christ came to the place, he looked up and then saw him, and said to him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must stay at your house. So he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. But when they saw it, they all complained, saying, He has gone to be a guest with a man who is a sinner. Then Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord, look, Lord, I give half of my goods to the poor, and if I have taken anything from anyone by false accusation, I restore fourfold. Verse number 9 to 10 says, and Jesus said to him, today salvation has come to this house, because he also is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. You understand? So the salvation work, or when God planned your life, it was not based on your perfection. That is what I need to let you understand today. That is why I say God still remembers you. God still remembers you. So forgive yourself. And don't allow any human being to condemn you. Stand strong and be ready or be willing to turn around from your sins. If you know of any sin, any familiar sin, anything that you intentionally do, ask God to forgive you. He is merciful. Our God is merciful. He is gracious. Oh, yes. He is a deliverer. He is a savior. He loves to save sinners. God loves to save sinners. That is what happened to Zacchaeus. So, it wasn't depend on your being perfect, never making a mistake, or never taking a wrong turn. No, God knew we would all make mistakes. You know, God knew you. All of us will make mistakes daily. It doesn't matter who you are. You can be saying you are so spiritual. You are so spiritual, it doesn't matter. You can sin. You and your wife. It happened to you and your wife. The way you talk to your wife. The way you make your wife feel. The way you make your husband feel. You know all these things are sin. You live with a woman, but sometimes look at the way you treat the woman. Look at the way you treat the man. And you are still a Christian. Look at the way you treat your own children. Look at the way you treat your friends. Look at the way you treat your parents. All these are sin, which you must ask for forgiveness. Look at the way you talk about your own pastor who preaches to you every day. It's all sin. That is why John says that if we confess our sins, and I want you to understand that the reason why you need to confess your sins and admit your sins is because God still remembers you. Sister, He remembers you. Oh, yes. All the things that you are going through, God still remembers you. So, just like there are many routes on a map, God has a plan to help you reach your destination. When I'm driving and I put on my GPS, I remember one time I drove from Maryland to New Jersey, and on my way coming to Maryland, I went somewhere deep in New Jersey, and I was using for the first time one particular GPS that I have never used before. I normally use Garmin GPS, but that day, I don't know, my GPS, I think I gave it to somebody, so I happened to use TomTom GPS. And this GPS, I'm not familiar with it. And this GPS took me to some areas, and it took me more than 2 to 3 hours to find my way to come to Maryland. You can't believe it. But you see, at the end of the day, the GPS finally directed me to my destination. That is what I'm saying. So whatever you are doing, you have been going through ups and downs as a Christian, God will definitely lead you to your destination as a child of God. He still loves you. He still remembers you. Just make a decision to repent. Just make a decision to confess and to stop and to get away from those things, and you'll be safe. God still loves you. He still remembers you. He remembers what you are going through in your marriage. He remembers that you are struggling, you have been praying, you need a child. He remembers you every day that your financial stage or status is not good. You are always in financial crisis. And God still remembers that. He knows it. You think God doesn't notice that you are in financial difficulties? You think God doesn't know that you are a single woman and you have over 30 years going to 40 years and you are still not married? God knows everything. At the end of the day, one day, I say one day, yes, one day, miracle. God has miracle one day. It takes just a second. When earthquake happens, it just happened in the twinkle of an eye in a second. Oh my God. Sometimes it's like 5 seconds, earthquake can destroy a whole thing. That is a miracle. Your miracle will happen like that. Your enemy will run away with his shoes in the name of Jesus Christ. You will see the glory of God. Just accept and begin to turn around to Jesus. So today, if you are feeling like you have been blown it, if you feel like you are too old, too far gone, or too far off track, know that nothing you have done, no mistake that you have made or ever will make, or you will ever make, is a surprise to God. There is nothing that is a surprise to God. The man you slept with him, although you have a husband and you have a wife, it's not a surprise to God. The asylum that you have been doing all the time, the gossip you have been gossiping about people, is not a surprise to God. God knows that you will sin. And that is why he sent his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, that when you receive him, you will have eternal life. Jesus is coming soon. Very soon, we're going to see Jesus Christ. So let's all repent from our sins. Let's confess. When we come together, we ask for forgiveness of sin, not because of anything, but God wants us to do that. God wants us to do that. It's a requirement. God richly bless you. God remembers you again. And God lead you and guide you. May he send his angels to be with you in whatever you do and wherever you go, by the grace of God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's sing this song and close again. Let's sing this song before I pray. So don't go away. Wait for me. Let's sing the song again. He keeps his covenant with you. God keeps his covenant with you. And covenant. He keeps his covenant. Mm-mm-mm.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Covenant keeping God. There is no one like the Almighty God, the creator of the universe. He loves you. He keeps his command. His agreement with you stands forever. That he has saved you. That he has saved you. All you need to do is to do your best to be under the canopy of the Almighty God. For the Bible says in Psalm 91 that they that dwell under the secret place of the Most High God, they shall abide. If you dwell under the secret place, under the presence of the Almighty God, you shall be abide. That means you will be protected from sickness. You will be protected from sudden death. You will be protected from demons hurting you. God will give you glory. We thank you. God, we bless your name for this morning for your word. I pray that your spirit will water this word, so that it will grow in the hearts and in the life of everyone that listens to this message on Facebook, on Prayer Land, on radio station. We thank you for this morning. We thank you that you are taking us far in the spiritual realm. We thank you that you are using us to break the shackles of the enemy that controls our mind, that controls our life. We give you glory for your angels that are with us. We thank you for the blood of Jesus that was shed on the cross of Calvary to save mankind. Father, I thank you for dear sister, for dear brother, for this meeting, for the fellowship. I thank you for the anointing and for the impartation. We shall never be the same. We continue to be blessing to others in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God richly bless you. Amen. So, sisters and brothers, I thank you for joining. And tomorrow morning, we begin a new week and we begin a new program, Monday to Friday, 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. Remember to be with us or to join us. And if you want to listen from United States or other countries, especially in Ghana, the time will be from 5 a.m. plus 4, 5 plus 4 is 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. We are always on here, on Facebook, and immediately after Facebook, we are on YouTube. So our programs are on YouTube. If you want to listen to this wonderful teaching again, go to YouTube and you can listen to it. Just type Hog Network. Hog Network, one word. It is one word, no space. If you look at my logo, the same here, Hog Network, then Space Radio. You find me, or you find our station on YouTube, and then you go to Hope of Glory Radio on Facebook all the time. You see us live. God richly bless you. Shall we all share the grace together? The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.